Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you the different data editors available in MAUI DataForm and how to create them easily. Look at this example, the form contains the country field, and when I type any character, the suggestions will be displayed. In the same field, you can render a combo box like this. First, I'll open an existing application, where I have already added the MAUI DataForm control with basic properties. To learn more about integrating the DataForm control into a MAUI application, please check the Getting Started video linked in the card above and the description below. Let me run this application by pressing the F5 key. Here is the data form with fields like first name, middle name, and so on. Notice that the date picker for date joined field. Address field has a multi-line editor. Checkbox for confirmed field. And all other fields are rendered with a text editor. You can change the editor type based on the data type. The data form supports built-in editors such as text, multiline text, autocomplete, combo box, and so on. Here I'm going to render the autocomplete control for the country field. First, I open the main page XAML CS file. Define the class ItemsSourceProvider extension. And this class implements the Syncfusion MAUI interface, DataFormSourceProvider. This interface is used to provide the method to get the source for picker type properties. I define a public method, getSource, that accepts the source name as an argument. Source name is nothing but model class field name to which I'm going to generate data. Here the field name is country. So, I add an if condition to check whether the source name is country. And define the list with string values. Next, to access the DataForm controls item source provider, I add the XName attribute as DataForm. Using that control reference, I'll access the item source provider. And initialize the item source provider extension class. Then call the register editor method to change the default editor. And pass the field name as country. And dateform editor type as autocomplete. Check the data form now. When I type a character on the country field, suggestions will be shown. Next, I change the data form editor type to combo box. Look now, the country field has a combo box editor, and you can select any country now. You can also bind data to the combo box using the GenerateDataFormItem event. First, I comment out the item source provider related codes. Then add the DataForm's GenerateDataFormItem and assign the callback method. I declare the onGenerateDataFormItem method with two arguments. Using this parameter, I add an if condition and check the data item is not null. And the field name is country. And editor type is combo box. I copy-paste this list and assign it to the item source of the ComboBox item. Make sure to enable the AutoGenerateItems, because this event will not be triggered when AutoGenerateItems is disabled. Check now, the ComboBox editor is rendered for the country. Finally, I'll show you how to create custom data editors. First, I add the SfDataForm.Items. Then add the DataFormTextItem field and map the field name to the first name field from the Employee Model class. In the same way, I add the text item for the last name field. I include the multi-line item and map the address field. Next, include the ComboBox item and map the field name country. Add the date item for the date joined field. And checkbox item for the confirmed field. Since I have defined the editor type, I disable the auto-generated items. Also, I don't need to call the registerEditor method and uncomment the item source provider related codes, since this event will not be triggered when AutoGenerateItems is disabled. And comment out the GenerateDataFormItem event related codes. Look here, the data form is rendered based on the specified editors. And country field has a ComboBox editor. Let me recap. I showed you the different data editors available in the MAUI DataForm and how to create data editors easily. You can download a working example of this from the GitHub link in the description for this video. I've also included a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.